Good morning, students. I hope everyone is safe. Yeah, happy Dasara to all of you. So already we are discussing about the formation of urine. So formation of urine occurs in four stages. The first one is glomerular filtration, already we discussed. And the second one is tubular reabsorption, already we discussed. So the third one is tubular secretion. The third one is tubular secretion. So what do you mean secretion? Secretion is nothing but the releasing of the substances is called as secretion. For example, you take salivary glands, they secrete saliva. Gastric glands, they secrete gastric juice. Means the releasing the substances is called as secretion. So already we discussed about the reabsorption. The reabsorption, what will happen? It occurs in the proximal convoluted tubule. It occurs in the PCT. In the PCT, the 75% of water and some nutrients, carbohydrates, glucose, amino acids, and some vitamins and substances, they are being reabsorbed by the proximal convoluted tubule. And from that, they enter into this peritubular network. It enters into the peritubular network. So the third stage is called as the tubular secretion. So this PCT, the urine enters into the loop of Henle. From the loop of Henle, it enters into the proximal distal convoluted tubule. It is called as distal DCC, distal convoluted tubule. So here, what will happen? The peritubular network, when the reabsorption occurs, only the waste materials and the little amount of water will be expelled. Then again entered into the added to the proximal mixed distal convoluted tubule. So what are they? They are urea. They are urea, uric acid, some salts, pigments, ions. What are the ions? Ions like potassium, sodium, chlorine, hydrogen. So such type of ions, they are again, which are not required for the body, which are not required, they are waste especially. So they are again added to the distal convoluted tubule. So this is called as the tubular secretion. So a small amount of tubular secretion also takes place in the proximal convoluted tubule. So this peritubular network, it maintains the pH value of the urine. So what is the pH value of the urine? So maintaining the hydrogen ion concentration in the urine is called as the pH concentration of the urine. So here if the hydrogen ions are more, they will be released, they will be removed from the body. Understand? So especially the nitrogen waste, urea, uric acid and the bile pigments and the unnecessary salts, especially sodium, potassium, chlorine, that's why the urine is a little bit salty in nature. Okay? So they will be added to the distal convoluted tubule. In the distal convoluted tubule, they enter into the connecting tubule. So this is about the tubular secretion. So now we will discuss about the fourth one, formation of hypertonic, formation of hypertonic urine. So here the urine is more diluted. So from the distal convoluted tubule, it enters into the collecting tubule. So when it enters the collecting tubule, if it is more diluted, so most of the water from our body will be removed in the form of urine. So that's why to make the urine more concentrated, a special hormone will be secreted from a gland that is called pituitary gland, and the hormone is called as vasopressin. Vasopressin is the hormone. It is added to the urine. So it makes urine more concentrated by diluted when it enters into the collecting tubules. So this hormone called as vasopressin, which is secreted by the pituitary gland, will be added here and makes the urine more concentrated. Then the urine will pass up to the pelvis, pelvis to ureter, ureter to reaches to the urinary bladder. So if this vasopressin is not added, not produced in the proper amount, then what will happen? So the person will pass the urine often and often. The more urine will pass it from our body, so this condition or this disease is called as diabetes insipidus. It is called as the diabetes insipidus. By taking the medicine, it will be cured. Okay, ma'am. So this is about the your formation of urine. So formation of urine occurs in how many stages? Four stages. The first one is glomerular filtration, then tubular reabsorption, tubular secretion, formation of hypertonic urine. So the glomerular filtration, the entire blood will be filtered, and this is called as the ultrafiltration. Okay, and the urine which is formed in the after the glomerular filtration is called as the primary urine. So the primary urine enters into the proximal convoluted tubules. So here the tubular reabsorption occurs in the proximal convoluted tubule. So all the nutrients, 75% of the water and the salts, amino acids, glucose, they all will be again reabsorbed by the tubule to the peritubular network. So this is called as tubular reabsorption. So after entering into the body, again the body sends back the waste materials. So the waste materials will be secreted through the distal convoluted tubule. It is called tubular secretion. So during the tubular secretion, the peritubular network, it will add it. It will bring the waste materials like urea, uric acid, salts, pigments, like and ions like potassium, sodium, calcium, hydrogen. So this peritubular network, it will maintain the pH value of the urine. Okay, so these are all materials along with the water that enters into the collecting tube. So this is called as tubular secretion. Then we come to the formation of hypertonic urine. Formation of hypertonic urine. So if the whatever may be collected in the collecting tube, the urine is very more diluted. So means the water should be removed from the urine. So to make the urine more concentrated, a special hormone will be added. So that is called as vasopressin. Since vasopressin is the hormone secreted by the pituitary gland and will be added to the urine in the collecting tubules. So when it is added in the collecting tubules, the urine will become more concentrated and enters into the urinary bladder. So if this vasopressin is not produced in the proper amounts, then a diluted urine will be passed out from the body often and often, and this disease and this condition is called as diabetes insipidus. In the next, this is about the formation of urine. In the next class, we will discuss about the ureters, urinary bladder, urethra, and how the urine will be passes out from our body.